On y a retrouvé la lune.
Everybody, can you sing that song?
You create a time, step out of time, to control the time you created. Oh no no, on y a retrouvé la lune. On y a retrouvé. Control the time you created. On your way to be done. You create a time. You create a time. Step out of time to control the time you created. Oh no no. On your way to be done.
Lift your hands and say,
God,
you are the timekeeper of my life. My timekeeper. You don't let me miss your time of your plan for your people. I don't know how you want to thank him, but this is another January 2023. We are here in 2022. We are here not to say, Lord, help us in 2022. Help us from the beginning to see the end. And they heard our prayers. And they have brought us again to January 2023. Go ahead and tell him, the Lord, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for the life you have given, for the life you have preserved, for the life you have sustained, for the hope you have redeemed, for the assurance you have given, for the values you have added, for the miracles you have added. We are simply going to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you for another season of 14 days with you. We come. Peter promised to say thank you. Our timekeeper, our sustainer, our sufficiency, our provider, our director, our preserver, our deliverer, our joy. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We are grateful. Your word said that where two or three have gathered in your name, there you are in the midst of them. Thank you for the assurance of your presence in our midst. Thank you because before we declare the 14 days fasting, you have already approved it, endorsed it, and blessed it. Thank you for every single day of these 14 days of encounter with you in this altar.
Thank you for the wars that are coming alive. Thank you for the wars that are coming with healing. Thank you for the wars that are coming to steer up our virtue that have gone to sleep. Thank you for the revival and renewal. And thank you for the mighty acts that will be celebrated by reason of this covenant prayer of corporate fasting and prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Go ahead and celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus and celebrate the anointed dominion voices. I've just demanded that they should add your pictures, your corporate pictures, in the group flyer for this fast, so that you know that you are just part of what God is going to use for this season. Hallelujah. This evening, I believe God that we shall be renewing our relationship with God, which begins with covenant. So the title of our focus tonight is Covenant Activation. I made a statement in my office. In life, there's nothing you want to do that you cannot do. And I'd like you to capture every few things I'm going to say now. There's nothing you want to do in life that you cannot do. The only thing you have to do to make sure you work out what your mind is telling you to do is to learn how to work it out. These principles hold in the positive, you hold in the negative. That's why people kill, and that's why people succeed. There's something in a man that God cannot do anything about. Okay? You have self-will, and you have a divine will. When you try to power your life with your self-will, you will do your own will outside of God's will. Are we here? And in that course, you can suffer. In that course, you can go down. In that course, you can miss your definition and your destination. I like people who are hungry, who hears a word and they look for their pain and they put it down. Whatever you put down sinks into your system. If you can't put it down, try to record it. And then you run with it. Are you here? If you choose to be poor, all right, you will know that you have chosen to be poor by the quality of your thought life. As he thinketh in his heart, so he is. If every time the only thing that comes to your mind is pain of your yesterday, envy of people around you who are succeeding, then you are someone who is not going to succeed. But if you are such a person who always look away from your yesterday and put your mind on your future, are we here? And then set your heart to celebrate with those that celebrate, no matter the size, you are going to become the next champion to be born. Are you hearing me? So in 2023, your prosperity and your wealth will begin with resetting your mind. I have long reset my mind. I've been talking, I asked one of my daughters this afternoon, you didn't see me yesterday, he said, Daddy, you said we should not be too familiar, so I ran. Praise God. I said, no, it's not to that extent. I miss you. Okay? Because I want us to release our faith with value. Are we here? I remember years back, we just finished a major service here on a Sunday. And somebody out of excitement was just coming. And now there was an anointing service. Out of excitement was just coming to my seat, unguided. I lift up my hand, and I saw the person lifted up. Praise God. Thank God Elizabeth has not gone out. They ran after her to pick her. There are times you meet a man of God when he has not come out from the altar. Praise God. And things can happen. I remember also somebody came to my office one day and said, let me just go and greet that this headache has stayed with me. She said in her heart, when I get there, once it shake me, this headache will go. Okay, I think that's Tokumbo. And she came. I didn't know what she was passing, but she said it in her heart. So in my mind, I am going to see my pastor. Are we here? So those are the kind of familiarity I was talking about yesterday. There's nothing you want to do, you cannot do. Are we here? There's no mountain you want to remove that you cannot remove. There's no problem created with you that is permitted to live with you. Are we here? There's enough power in your spirit, enough authority in your spirit, enough energy in your spirit. Are we here? Whatever you cannot do is what you have not decided to do. Listen to me, people of God. Laziness and sleeping is the foundation of poverty. Bible says a little sleep. And what again? That slumber is another name for laziness. Okay? When you sleep and wake out of sleep and wake out of sleep and go back to sleep and you want money. Oh my God. God doesn't give money to sleepers. God give money to workers. Are we here? There's enough grace to work out your world. Whatever makes your eye to be closed while people are on the street pursuing money, say to that thing in 2023, you cannot find me. My prayer that God will give you help. Are they here? Somebody here? God will do what? Good health. There is nothing you want to do. One of my sons was telling me yesterday, Daddy, I want to do this, I want to do this. But I decided in my mind to do this. I just looked at him the way he was talking. He was talking out of inspiration. And I listened to my spirit. By the time he finished, I said, boy, you can do both. Praise God. Because two of them were coming out of his mind. And he was talking with certainty. And I said, you can do both. Help me tell somebody, there's nothing you want to do in life that you cannot do. We only have to cultivate the will to work it out. Work it out. The Bible says, work out your salvation with what? Fear and trembling. God doesn't give you a thought for joke. See, the theme of this fasting is supernatural enlargement. And they have to do with your mind. So this first day, I am going to talk to your mind. And I will talk to your mind in such a way that you will get back to your mind and stop blaming your environment. Sometimes I say to myself, if I had known what I know now, years back, before I met the Lord, I wouldn't have been where I am. Principle 2, make your knowledge of God to override the knowledge of your problem. Make your knowledge of God to do what? Override the knowledge of your problem. Every problem is revealed by what they are. But there's something bigger than the problem. So get to know something bigger than your pain and something bigger than your problem. And the problem will disappear. Come on, are we here? If you are too convinced that the devil is behind what is happening to you, get a conviction that God is bigger than the devil who is behind what is going through in your life. Are we here? You see, you need to rise above the level of your enemies. Don't accept to stay at the level the enemy has programmed you to stay. Reject it, refuse it, and remember that God did not say that whatever you bind shall be bound and whatever you lose shall be loose. Job for entertainment. It's an authority of your covenant life. And it's given to you to exercise it. Can I hear someone say, whatever I bind shall be bound. Whatever I lose shall be loose. My spirit is alive. I have an authority in Christ. And I have dominion in Christ. Over all internal problems and external problem in 2023. Whatever I bind shall be bound. Whatever I lose shall be loose. Are we here? I know that one time of life in this year, you will hear this voice re-echoing. This problem. I know something bigger than you. Okay, I was sharing with somebody yesterday. I said, if God said in Haggai, okay, and that is the scripture I use when I have to deal with my finances. He said, the silver is what? And the gold. Yet a little while, I will shake the heavens and the earth and the desire of all nations. So I am a nation by God's definition. The desire of all nations shall be given. So if I am a child of God in the covenant with God, and the silver belongs to my father and the gold belongs to my father, why am I poor? So my poverty is not the will of God for me in the covenant. So I need to examine myself. Am I actually in the covenant? If you are a poor child, you will be disenfranchised from the will. But if you are a legitimate child, you will have a right to the will. Is that correct? Listen to me. If the silver belongs to God and the gold belongs to God, and this money and dollars and pounds and naira will not go back to heaven, they were delivered for my sustenance, what is wrong with me that I'm not having access to them? What are the principles of God I need to watch at? Early this year, we began to deal with forgiveness. And many of you are still explaining why you must not forgive. It doesn't matter what has been done against you. The Bible said in Matthew chapter 6, forgive us our trespasses as he forgiving those who has trespassed against us. Somebody has trespassed against you, you can't let go. You can't forgive because the person insulted you and he has messed you up. And you are asking God to forgive you. That may be one of the major reasons for your poverty. Because there will be a disconnection of God's hand on your life. Your prayers may not be answered. God will shut the heart of people over your life. You cry, they will not hear. So such principles are not given to you to negotiate. In 2023, you have to die to your flesh to come alive in righteousness so that your prayers shall be answered. The time of passing is not the time of pointing fingers. Point to the eyes. Point to the nose. Point to the leg. If you are pointing one finger, 10 fingers will be pointing at you. Are we here? Stop hindering yourself and come alive and begin to do what God wants you to do. Are you here? Another principle is, what is my compliance to God's financial principles? Am I a tither? Am I a giver? What is my attitude when it comes to the culture of giving? He said, give, and what will happen? It shall be given to you. Great measure, shaking together, shall be given to you. And the Bible says, there's one that has and scattereth, yet he increaseth. Yet there's one that has and withholdeth more than what is necessary, and they turn it to poverty. Have you not read it? So check your principles and find out where you are lacking. And then begin to adjust. That is Proverbs chapter 11, verse 24. Number three principle tonight. The price you are not willing to pay is a value you are not ready to take delivery of. I said it to those of you that were ordained late last year. The price you are not willing to pay is a value you are not ready to take delivery of. Fasting and prayer is a culture of price to pay. Somebody, are you here? When you are too weak, I have told you, if you cannot fast, don't force yourself to fast. But this prayer, don't miss it. Praise God. Come as you are enabled. Pay the price. Fasting is a private price that provoke a public reward. When you have done it secretly, when God begins to deal with you, everyone will know that God has visited you. Come on, are we here? Those who run away from spiritual exercises end up remaining the same way they are from year to year. As you open up the year with a major price to pay, God is going to drive you with speed to become what he has to tell you to become. Somebody, are you here? So the price you are not willing to pay is the value you are not ready for. To forgive is a price. To let go is a price. To lay down is a price. Whatever price you are not willing to pay. To wake up and pray is a price. Are we here? So everything you are not willing to do are things that God will never do. Number four and the last one. In 2023, I touched it yesterday. I'll still touch it again tomorrow. In 2023, listen to me. Get upgraded. Help me tell somebody, get upgraded. Shout it like you mean it. You see, there is always a season that inspires season. As he thinks in his heart, you can't be thinking like a baby every year. It means you are not growing. Are we here? You can't be seeing one thing every year. There's need to see a new thing. See a new word. Sing a new song. Are we here? Tell yourself, this year, I'm not going to dress anyhow. Praise God. Some of you since New Year have been looking at the way you are dressing. It's very intimidating. Praise God. And that is repackaging. It's very good. Keep it up. Somebody said, is this cloth? People will think there's something. At least physically you look good. Are we here? Nobody is going to ask you. Nobody is going to ask you how you day when your appearance look very disturbing. You are not mad. Are we here? Your brain is still normal. Now money you no get. Take cloth, cover the money. Come on, are we here? In fact, you can buy wrapper 2000, 2005. That's kids. Call them. Tell them make them swim like Abada one. Are we here? Now money, now you no get. Okay? But sense you get. And if you get sense, you no get money. Now time and season. Very shortly, the sense where you get go bring the money where you need. Come, are we here? Idea is the currency of heaven. The best thing God gives to a wise man like Noah is idea. When he gives you idea, he knows he wants to make your future. He gave Isaac idea, Abraham idea, David idea. Are you here? So when you get idea and begin to package and run your idea, you will change your level. Okay? So my resetting begins from the inside. Listen, in 2023, get upgraded and you'll become engaged. People that have never said to you, how you day? I was asking my daughter, I said, how you? He said, I said, what is new? He said, nothing. I said, nobody is saying hi. He said, nobody. I said, oh, you don't know how to greet somebody. Said, look, you must live in such a state of mind that your expectation powers your daily life. Come on, are we here? I get disappointed if for a long time my phone did not ring. I'm not talking of a lot. Somebody should at least ask of me. So if you're not relating, nobody can relate with you. Check the church platform. Everybody celebrate bad day. Nobody knows your bad day. The day they put that today's your bad day, nobody goes there to say happy bad day. The question is, during people's bad day, how many people did you greet? How many people, if you can't tie, say something with your mouth and record it. Tell people to show you how to record. Are we here? Let your voice be heard. Come on, are we here? Change your style. Change your style. Change your culture in the environment. Change the hour you pray and change the way you come to church. I was telling Tony, I said, I'm going to lay hand on him. That will be next Sunday. Praise God. Because that's a young man that loves God so well. But I wouldn't know why he comes to close church. Praise God. All those things need to change. When you change those things, are we here? Okay, people are dancing. And you're just looking at them as if you are the one they're dancing to. They're dancing to their God in heaven. And you are busy. Sometimes you don't even dance well. That is the level they can dance. Leave them to their God. Shine your shine. They will shine their shine. What people are doing that is making them well. Okay? Don't assess them. Because the whole thing is going to God. Only God sees your heart level. I'll come back to this. Praise God. Now, this was what I saw in Abraham. Abraham upgraded his conscience. Are we here? Against the level of the tradition of his father. He changed the way he was reasoning. He changed the way he was perceiving things. He was not going to do what others are doing. He was going to do something different. So when they were expecting him to go into polygamy, he said, no. I've watched people who went into polygamy and the prices they paid. I am not ready for it. I'm not going to marry a second wife. I'm not going to cheat on my wife. He stood. In every state, God has allowed my marriage. I am going to take it like that. God saw it. God may not hear what you say, but God sees what you think. Are we here? And God said to him, leave where you are and follow me. He suffered poverty, he suffered delay, he suffered mockery, and but God separated him. Immediately God separated him, like in 2023. The next thing that happened, like in February, was that he became wealthy. Your wealth will come very fast this year. Are we here? He renounced the covenant of his father and then embraced the covenant of Jehovah. There was something I was trying to do, and my cousins gathered and they were telling me, they say you want to do, demand that you give us goat. I said, goat? They said, yes. I said, in the name of Jesus, I come with the lamp of God. And I said, behold the lamp of God that cometh in the name of the Lord. I am not here to be converted to the tradition that I have renounced. And I opened my boot and I brought a drink that looked like the blood of Jesus. I gave to all of them. And I told them, Jesus is the lamp of God. All of you went to church. You go to church, they say yes. They say, we have said, now we would have done this thing for ourselves. Our shell don't spoil. Don't ever allow them to convert you from where God has converted you to. Are we here? This is what I learned from Abraham. He was very sensitive of the time. He allowed his conscience to be renewed. And then he moved his conscience to follow the will of God, which is superior to the will of his father. Now, how did it happen? He had an encounter. Somebody say an encounter. When he had that an encounter, God transformed his conscience. The way he reasoning changed. In this meeting, you will have an encounter. He had a supernatural encounter and he had angelic encounter. When he had a supernatural encounter, he began to walk with God. The delay was there. And suddenly, he had an angelic encounter. Are we here? And then the witchcraft was removed, because when he had the angelic encounter, it cost him a sacrifice. When he had the supernatural encounter, it cost him nothing. It only cost him a renewed mind of full worship. So he followed God. Follow God. So in chapter 17, God said, you have paid no price for this relationship. And so by chapter 18, chapter 17, he paid the price of circumcision. By chapter 18, he paid the price of generosity. He fed angels. And merely the angels finished eating the food that Sarah had prepared. They said to Abraham, where is Sarah? Who served the food? Come on, are we here? Sarah was there, but it was not noticed. He came out like a sister to Abraham. He came out with such a good cook. Many of you, like my wife, have been cooking for this church 22 years now, 23 years. God should bless you more than enough if you can do it with your heart. Like Tukumbo have been serving, okay, in such a serious capacity. Elizabeth have been providing services in every area on cooking. They have God once asked about where you are about. In 14 days, many of you, because you are paying this price, you will have an encounter. There was a time Mama Comfort was cooking for us in the, is it PFN? In workers meeting here. And the food was delicious. Who stopped you? Praise God. In these 14 days, cook for us one day. Praise God. That's what to do. Sarah only cooked. Angel began to look for him. As you wait on God in these 14 days, your angel shall look for you and locate you. You will have an encounter that will change your life. You have an encounter that will change your world. You have an encounter that will change your family. You have an encounter that will change your life and change your business in the name of Jesus. Tonight I want us to pray for an encounter. Get on your feet. I'll continue from where I stop tomorrow. Come on, are we here? Lift your voice and thank God for the word and counsel that you have received. Lift your voice and say to God, thank you for this sacred season of prayers. I've come because you are my God. I come in the name of the Lord. The Bible says, blessed is a day that cometh in the name of the Lord. I've come in your name, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the Lily of Valley, the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, the Mighty God, my refuge. Lord, I've come, and there's 14 days I need an encounter. Somebody now begin to pray. Lord, and there 14 days, give me an encounter that will transform my life and transform my world. I pray for an encounter. A lady kataya rania kalada bada a rekata sutia nananayaga a lagada gada 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 a busuka pataliana gada e ranana kata lada badutara a ramado kapataya. An encounter that will transform my conscience. An encounter that will turn my life around. An encounter that will flush my conscience from every deadly thought in the name of Jesus. Give me an encounter that will flush my conscience from dead thoughts, from sin, and unprofitable issues. Flush my conscience. Take away anything in my mind that is undermining the plans and thoughts of God for my life. Change my life from the inside. Abraham was changed, and Abraham moved away from the natural to the supernatural. I need an encounter with you, the supernatural, whose name is God and divine. Lord, I pray for supernatural encounter. I pray for supernatural encounter. I need an encounter in my night. I need an encounter. I need an encounter in my prayer life.
an encounter in my ideal life, an encounter in my dream life. Lord Abraham had an encounter. I ask for encounter by power, encounter by the blood of Jesus, encounter, supernatural encounter. Lord, that thou shalt visit me, and thou shalt visit my spirit, and thou shalt visit my body, that there shall be an alignment, that you take me from where I am to your plan for my life. I need an encounter that will separate my life and my family away from poverty, from hardship, from wickedness and bewitchment. An encounter that will separate my name from hardship, my family from poverty, from bewitchment, and from every hardship. I declare, oh God, give me an encounter that will turn my life around. An encounter, and oh God, an encounter that will separate all from, oh God, poverty, witchcraft, evil, envy, wickedness. I command, oh God, an encounter of transformation in the name of the above every name. An encounter that will bring a turnaround, that will bring a change in the words of our heart and our business. An encounter, one encounter that will turn this around, one encounter that will bring a transformation, one encounter that will bring a surprise. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, I need an encounter that will uproot the source of my problems, the source of my delay, the source of my setback, and set it on fire. I need an encounter that will drain the root cause of my problem, the root cause of my delay, the root cause of my ups and downs. An encounter by the Holy Ghost, like Abraham. An encounter that will tell my story. An encounter that will change the world around me. An encounter that will bring my healing. An encounter that will change my level. An encounter that will break and upgrade. An encounter, oh God. Pray that God shall give you an encounter that will qualify you to know the voice of God or the voice of your enemy. Oh God, that from now in 2022, I shall come, oh God, under alignment to hear your voice, to know your voice, to know the sound of heaven, and to follow the sound of heaven. That beginning from tonight, I shall be able to know when God is speaking, what God is saying, and how God is saying, and what to do. I need an encounter to hear a voice, a sound of heaven, by the wind of God. I need an encounter. I need a patua. Regedegede. Akaba kalada. Yakata talala. Ikadadadadala. Zalaka patala. Akaladia pata. Radananananana. Iradadadadada. Iragadadadada. Iragadadadada. Ayagadadadada. I return my life to my God. You are my creator. You are my maker. You are my redeemer. Everything you are not deposited in my life, in my heart, in my body. I need an encounter that will disconnect them and flush them out of my life, out of my words. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And God separated Abraham as he was moving
People were mocking him. But God has said to him, whoever that curse you shall be cursed. Amen. That when you are doing the will of God, people that will rise up to be mocking you will encounter the judgment of God. In 2023, your mocker shall become a mockery. There are some of you that in a way to dodge the mockery, you will be reconverted to the same group that have kept you bound. Listen to me. God is moving you to your next level. You will sing a new song. A sound of praise shall be heard in your house. In the name of Jesus. God said to me, in blessing, I will bless you. That means that what he was trying to stay there to wait for will make him more poor. Because as you move in blessing, I will bless you. And I will make you a blessing. That is your promise for 2023. Early in January, God will bless you and make you a blessing. Can you raise your voice and say, Lord, I need an encounter that will bring your blessing upon my life and make me a blessing to my generation. An encounter that will turn things around in my wife, turn things around in my world, turn things around in my family and make me an answer and a solution, a blessing to my generation. Bless me, oh God. Bless me with spiritual blessing. Bless me with money. Bless me with opportunity. Bless me with wealth. Bless me with customer. Bless me with opportunity that will turn this around on my behalf. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I ask for wealth. I ask for wealth like Abraham. Abraham became rich. Abraham became rich in cattle, in silver, and in gold. Lord, bless me and make me, oh God, bless. In Jesus' name we pray. Listen, Abraham's covenant with God was revived and activated. Only one encounter, a God threefold world. The Bible said became rich in silver, in gold, and in cattle. Chapter 13, verse 2. He got converted in chapter 12. Are we here? From verse 2. So it is possible for anything to happen to you this year. Listen to me. Only one favor can make you a news to your generation. That favor can come by this encounter. When you have an encounter, heaven will command the earth concerning you. Are we here? One encounter. God will go to a man in a position and reposition the man and connect the man to your life, and your world will change. Lord, I need an encounter of favor in 2023 that will make me a news to my generation. An encounter of favor that will make me a news to my generation. An encounter of favor. Favor in the walls of my heart. Favor in my marriage. Favor in my house. Favor in my life. An encounter that will make me a news to my generation. God shall favor you with husband. He shall favor you with children. He shall favor you with car. He shall favor you with customer. Just one favor that will turn your life around. It shall happen in the 14th day. Lord, I command my favor. One favor. I command my favor. Favor me, oh God, with healing of my body. Healing of my body. Healing. And connect me to opportunity that will turn my destiny around. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Lift up your hands. God, whose name is the wind, and who rise on the wings of the wind, who is the owner of silver and gold, who is the shaker of the heaven and the earth that he created, I command by the anointing upon this meeting, it shall send the wind of favor upon your foundation. Every enemy of your favor shall go down. Wind of favor shall blow in your foundation. Wind of favor shall blow in your house. Wind of favor shall blow in your name. Wind of favor shall blow in your family. Wind of favor shall blow in your life, in your business, in 2023. In the name of Jesus. For these 14 days, those of you who signed up this form yesterday to bear the burden of the campground, we have seen your requests. We prayed on this by 12 o'clock, by 3 o'clock today. God helping us, we pray throughout the hourly for the 14 days. You signed this to bear the burden with the church for the campground to become actualized. We speak to this your prayer request. The Lord will bear your own burden. The wind of God that bears burden, it shall blow on your request. In 14 days, your request shall become a testimony. Upon those requests that will be added, it shall become a testimony. And the campground goes up, your life goes up, your project goes up, and the power of God shall envelope your life. In the name of Jesus. Come, let me anoint your hand to go and receive your favor. This anointing is double. It's a supernatural oil for empowerment and impartation. Don't worry about your hands. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, rest to your feet. We are done. We are going to target to close you by 7:30. Are we here? Or if I start flowing what is in my spirit, we'll keep you for vigil. It's a long time. But God will smile on you. In this 14 days, we run diesel for 14 days. You know what it means? A liter is 900 naira. So we need not just an offering. We need sponsors for the program. But please, don't stay away from this meeting because you don't have offering. Once you have your transport, please come. Praise God. The Lord himself will power the program. We will be supporting those of our staff